And we're live again. Yes. Smoking a homemade cigar here. I made it about a year ago. It's already got a little plume. Looking nice. Bunch of bike riders riding down the hill there. People love a steep hill, that's for sure. I think they woke up that dude that was sleeping over here. I think he went down there to sleep. All these bike riders just woke him up again. Poor guy. A good cigar. It's different. It's unusual. I don't even know how to describe it. It's like it definitely tastes homemade, but not in a bad way. It's just different. One thing, I didn't roll it. It's not real dense. I mean, it's all right. It's pretty good. You can see it's pretty normal, but a little bumpy and whatnot. But almost got a little bit of like a floral thing going on. It's different. I feel like even if you use the tobaccos, same tobaccos they use in normal store-bought cigars, I feel like it's still gonna taste different depending on the density that you roll it. So this one's maybe a little less dense than most cigars this size. The draw is effortless draw. It's got a nice, interesting sort of floral. Kind of floral, like a little bit of a hay thing going on. Good cigar. It's good. It's interesting. I don't think it's real sweet. There's maybe a touch of sweetness in here, but sometimes a cigar is good in that it's interesting, I'd say. There you go. Yeah, I have to say, I'm kind of proud of myself. I mean, I haven't tried too many Cubans, but I did try some Monte Cristo Cuban Monte Cristos once. I got an airport in Amsterdam, and I think this is better than them. I like that it's not packed real tight. I mean, the draw is just easy as anything. So we'll be doing some, we'll be doing some things. I got some good reviews in the works. I'm going to be coming out with some stuff, you know. I got some stuff coming, some new stuff, and we'll be doing that for sure. But right now, we're just going to take time to hang out. Sometimes you got to, give your nose a break. Just hang out, smoke a good cigar. And, I do have a little bit of that synthetic neroli on, which just smells nice. It's not real strong, but just smells nice on the skin. I like to have a cigar for breakfast. Some people think you should eat before you smoke a cigar. Well, I guess if you're not, if you just don't enjoy it unless you eat, okay. But I enjoy a cigar for breakfast, and I'm drinking some coffee with cream. So that's a little something. But I couldn't tell you exactly what the cigar. I think it has a Habano 2000 wrapper, and I'm guessing probably some Nicaraguan Seco, because I use that all the time when I make cigars. Possibly some Paraguayan Seco, and I'm sure it's got some Ligero in there. It's running a little bit on one side. There's probably a little Ligero on this side. But I'd say it's burning pretty good. Looks like it might catch up. Probably not the most captivating host, I guess. I should come up with some more things to talk about here today. But I don't know, I'm just enjoying the day. It's kind of a nice, bright day, though. It's like there's no clouds, but there's like a thin layer of cloud. Kind of the sky is kind of opaque today. I'm going to touch it up a little bit. It's just running too much for my liking. There we go. Hopefully that'll catch it up. Smoking good. I mean, I get a lot of smoke off this thing. Mm-hmm. hair sticking out. I put a lot of Ligero in mine. That's one thing I think makes my cigars kind of, you know, like a signature thing, is I put a ton of Ligero in, at least proportionally. And I think it's all that Ligero that makes the cigar change a lot as it burns. So this is changing. It gets sweeter. Richer and stronger. Yeah. Maybe the Ligero wasn't, you know, coming to the foot, because I was a little sloppy when I made a lot of these. So might not have had much Ligero in the very first third, but now it's hitting that Ligero hard. Yeah, it's all about the Ligero. You know, they say the Ligero just gives it strength, but I say it gives it a lot of flavor, too. That's nice. I mean, this thing's smoking like any good cigar. Now it's like a nice draw. Really good flavors. I gotta say, I found myself wanting to reach for this instead of a different cigar. I have a bunch of cigars, but I found myself wanting one of these. These are kind of special, you know. I mean, I know they're a year old. They've been in the humidor for a year, and I know sort of what's in them. I tried for a while putting bands on them with exactly what was in them, but it's too much, and I found I really didn't care that much about it. I like being surprised a little bit. This is good. Yeah, this thing has really picked up. Like, this second third is so much better than it was in the beginning. It wasn't bad in the beginning. It was just sort of this interesting floral thing. And it was kind of mild, but now it's real full-bodied, strong. Nice sweetness. I mean, this now it tastes like, you know, like a $16 cigar. I would put this up, this flavor, I would put up against any cigar. The draw, too. I would put this draw on this cigar up against any cigar. Now, the construction, the bumpiness, the veininess, the unevenness, yeah, you got me there. But the draw and the flavor, yeah, you're not going to beat this. Thank you. I'm really impressed with this cigar. I mean, I'm pretty impressed. I rolled this. I think it's the year. That year put some nice flavor in this thing. But yeah, I'm pretty darn impressed with this thing. It's good. I did pick a good one, like a good looking one out of the bunch. There's a real sweetness to that on this wrapper too. Pretty sure this is a Habano 2000 wrapper. There's a nice sweetness on this thing. I think Castro would be happy with this. Honestly, do. I mean, I smoked that aging room Quattro last night, which I thought was amazing. And I might say this is better than that. I think this is better than that. This one's got more going on, at least. It's like... this thing is just changing all over the place. Yeah. Look at that ash. You know it's good when you get a nice big ash like that. Just nice, like a nice big ash. Well, I'm sorry, all I can do is tell you about it. You can't go get one. There's a one of a kind right here. But even though it's a one of a kind, you could start making your own cigars, and you could definitely make some one of a kind amazing cigars, but let's just, first off, you got to learn how to roll. You got to get the stuff you need, the mold, you got a pizza cutter, you got to get the leaves. You got to learn about the moisture content of the leaf you need, like how much moisture is just right to roll for each thing. You need a lot of moisture for the wrapper and the binder, or not that much for the binder, but a lot for the wrapper, a little bit more for the binder, a little less for everything else. You got to learn some things, then you got to roll for a while, and then you get to feel, then you roll one like this. Then you let it put in a box and put in a well-controlled humidity box, humidor or whatever, and then you let it sit for a year, and then smoke it, and you might get something pretty darn good like that. Yeah, this is how you smoke it. Who they got a name? Burns. What is that comedian name? You know, the cigar. Well, this is the Burns style. That's how you hit a cigar if you're... what the hell is his first name? Something Burns. Whatever, you know what I'm talking about. That's how he does it. Just a nice little kiss. I usually smoke more like... people wanted to say Robert Burns. I think that's like a poet or something. What was his name? Great. I know it was Gracie Allen and something Burns. What the heck is his name? What the hell is that guy's name? George Burns, right? Is it George Burns? Yeah. George Burns. Yeah, that's how George Burns smokes it. It just kind of... Let's see, George Burns cigar hit. He's talking, blah, blah, blah. That's it. Not me. One thing, okay, I'll give it one knock. It's starting to get a little hot, like down here already. It really shouldn't be hot at all. And I assume that's because it's not packed very densely. But you can see there's not that much give. I mean, there is a little bit, see? But it's not crazy. But, yeah, if I could pack them a little bit more densely, that'd probably be perfect. Although the give is kind of nice when you, on the cigar, when you have a little give, it's kind of nice. You don't have to work. This is a perfect size. See, this is like a Corona, a little bit bigger, maybe. It's a about a Corona size, and this is the perfect size to smoke for just, you know, you don't have to get lockjaw trying to smoke this thing. Plenty of smoke, lots of flavor. Really, the only knock I would give it is that, to me, it seems maybe a little bit hot, but that might be just smoking it too fast, you know? But, yeah, I to be honest, I mean, the construction's not perfect, but I'm pretty darn impressed what a regular guy can do. I mean, I just got the tobacco and kind of followed a couple videos and rolled them up. Some are better than others, but just a matter of paying attention and staying focused when you're rolling them. You know, the ones where you really pay attention, they're usually good. I can tell this is one where I was focused and I rolled it. Cigar is so good. I can't shut the video off. I gotta just keep on smoking it. This is a very fragrant cigar, too. It smells great. Neroli. That stuff's so nice on the skin. I feel like this is one that would not be that good in the relight, so I'm just going to relax and smoke it. This is a good cigar. This is a cigar that is really, to me, is worth smoking in one go. Just checking the old Facebook here. Nothing going on there. This cigar is nice. I would say it's different than that aging room cigar. I'm not going to say it's better, because that one was really good in a different way. It's a little darker, kind of a richer. This one is more of a morning type cigar. Where I rolled it, I must have had more Ligero in the middle, because it seems like it's kind of mellowing out a little bit more than it was now. Still got a nice sweetness, though. This thing's got picked up a really nice sweetness. I always do a flag around the head, kind of a double thing, so when you're chomping on it, you don't get it, you know, you don't go through the cigar. See, I always have kind of a little itch to talk like that when I smoke a cigar. Yeah. Yeah, see? You always be second best as long as I'm around, see? Let it chill a little bit. I don't like to smoke cigars that get too hot. I don't want to let them get too hot. Yeah, I think I probably ought to call this video a day, huh? All right, well, have a good one, and see you in the next one. Don't be late.